Hallelujah. Give God glory in this house on this first Sunday of August. We have made it to the first Sunday of August. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you for your loving kindness, your tender mercy. Father, you have been good to us. You've been more than kind to us, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Father, you have allowed us to come to another week. And for that, we say thank you, God. Father, we ask that you have your way of the service home today, God. In the name of Jesus, have your way, God, and every soul, God. In the name of Jesus, stop this fresh oil, fresh anointing come in this place, God. Take over this place, God. In the name of Jesus, have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. In the name of Jesus, God, have your way in this place, God. Come to Lord us again, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, be with us again. In the name of Jesus, Father, bless our pastor right now. Bless our pastor right now, God. Anoint him afresh, oh God. In the name of Jesus, that we put the word, God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, you get the glory of the Lord, God. Get the glory of the Lord, God. In the name of Jesus, and that we get the glory of his praise. Everything belongs to you, God. Of Jesus and all that he has done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. Somebody lift your voice and say, hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Lift your voice one more time. Hallelujah. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Excuse me. Come on, let's go in. How do you know that he reigns forever? He reigns forever. Look at the neighbor in your bedroom. In the mansion. In the mansion.
Thank you.
given to God, I serve honor. And I want Mother Martin, all you can do is say hello. Just say hello, Mother Martin.
Thank you. Thank you. right where you are.
No matter where you are or what you're doing, I just need you to take a moment to worship God.
Hallelujah.
Tell God, God, you are my everything. You are my all. And that I can't live without you.
Yes, sir.
I can't live without you. Come on, take a moment and just begin to minister to God. How can you minister to him? You can dedicate yourself to him, your life, my all, my hands, my feet, my mind, my will, my way. Come on, dedicate yourself to God. Come on. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. 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 Come on, just give them your praise. Give them your glory. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Clap your hands, all ye people. Shout out to God with a voice of triumph. Amen. Father, we thank you and we bless you for these few moments. God, I pray that those that heard today the word, even through song, that it has blessed. That it has blessed. And I pray, God, that the words that we speak, Father, that you will bless the heart or soul to even come to the knowledge that I am nothing without you. So, Father, I pray that you will save a lost soul. Those who are on their way to a hell eternally, Father, that you will save. That young man, that young woman, that lady, that boy, that girl, save in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Thank you, choir. Thank you. Thank you for your help on today. We make you welcome again to the New Mission Temple Church of God in Christ. I'm not going to be long, so what I want you to do is I want you to get your grapes, your grape juice, and your crackers. We're going to be having communion in a few moments. We are truly in a very serious time. Before I go into my few words, I just want to thank God for Mother Rosie Martin.
Amen.
Amen. Come on. Amen. I want you to say in your thank God for Mother Rosie Martin. Amen. Mother Rosie Martin was in the hospital for over a month. She had coronavirus. She had pneumonia. There was a lot of things going on with her. But you know what? She's here.
Yes.
She's here today. And can I bring this a surprise? It's not going to be a surprise after this. But she's bringing the word on next Sunday.
All right.
She's bringing the word on next Sunday. But we are truly in a pandemic time. Amen. This is a time. Thank God for our sister Constance. Constance coming in on today. Amen. But it was something that she said to me. She was talking. And we were talking about how the love of men of God, the love of God has waxed cold in so many hearts. Generations have not known God. We started not just during the month of March or January or February, but it started generations ago when people decided that I'm not going to even make my children do what I was ordered to do. I want you to know that by design, God has brought us to this place. He has brought us to this place in history. And it is incumbent upon us to stay close to God.
Amen.
To stay connected. I want you to stay connected. Just tell somebody, stay connected. It is incumbent upon you. There's a lot of false rumors, of false accusation, fake news. There's a lot of things going on. Amen. But stay connected. So therefore, during this time, is it incumbent upon you that you get close to God, my brother and my sister. Get close to God. Get close to God. How am I going to stay close to God when the churches are closed? Help us.
Oh my.
Well, God is in the church, but more importantly, God is in you. God is in the building, but God is in you. get in your word. Go through these weekly and daily and times of just getting close to God. I find myself getting up early every morning. There are people that I don't even know that go forth in praise and work in prayer. I don't know these people, they may not ever know me, but I'm with them in prayer. People from all over the world, all over the country. Find some people, find some places where you can get in your time of just being reconnected with God. It is for purpose that we have come to this point. So God just wants to see what people are made of. It's like this is really a war zone.
Yes, it is.
It's like all of a sudden you train for war. You train for war.
Well,
and all of a sudden when you're on the front lines, then you can't do what it is that you have been trained to do because of fear.
Well,
I want you to know that God has not given us a spirit of fear. So I want you to know I trust God. Can I tell you, I just need somebody to tell me I trust God. I trust God with everything, my mind, my will. I trust God with my soul. And not only do I trust God, but I trust Him for my family, my brothers, my sisters. I trust Him for my children, my grandchildren, whoever it is. I trust God for the members of this church. I trust God. I'm nothing. I want you to turn to Exodus, the 33rd chapter. And this is a prayer I want you to pray all week long.
Thank you.
During this time, I want you to pray this prayer. Father, I can't do this without you. Father, I can't do this without you. I want you to turn to Exodus, the 33rd chapter, and starting at the 13th verse, it was a simple request. After the children of Israel had perpetually sinned against God, and yet God would allow them to be punished, but yet God was always close to bring them through and to bring them out. How many of you have perpetually went against the desire of God for your life? But yet when you look around, I'm yet blessed. When you think how your thing's over, like the song said, I'm truly blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed coming in. I'm blessed going out. I'm just blessed. Even in your darkest day, you're yet blessed. Mother Martin, she's here in the room today. Amen. But she's blessed. Especially somebody may have thought that it was over. But you know what? God said not so. She got some more preaching to do. She got some more teaching to do. Some more wisdom to be given out. I want somebody to know it's not over. I want you to know it's not over. God said it's not over. And so you got to hold on to the word of God. But what you got to do is you got to hold on to God. He said in the 33rd chapter and the 13th verse, he says, now therefore I pray thee if I have found grace in thy sight. If I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I might find grace in thy sight again, and consider that this nation is thy people. And this way it gets really funny. God said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. My presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest.
Amen.
Listen, you ever talk to somebody in life, and you know when they're giving you an answer that we're done, it's over. I don't care what you do, you can move on.
Yeah.
What did he say? And he said unto him in the 15th verse, and if thy presence go not with me, carry us not up from here. Your presence is not going with us, Lord. Don't take me from this spot. It's interesting. Don't take me from this spot. Right here is where you are. Your presence is right here. But if you're telling me to go, I got you. Go. But wait a minute. You're not saying I'm going in the front. I'm going in the back. The glory of God. Listen. The glory of God from the Exodus, from their Exodus out of Egypt. The Bible says that the glory of God came in the front and came in the back. It led them. It told them when to stop. It took care of them. But now God is saying, go. Amen. So he said, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not up from here. For wherein shall it be known that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight? It is not in that thou goest with us. So shall we be separated? Shall we be separated? Moses made a declaration to God that, God, I can't do this without you. I can't do this without you. Your presence must go with me. Your presence must be with me. I need somebody to say, God, I can't do this. I can't preach like you want me to do. I can't unless your presence go with me. The power of the Holy Ghost. The power of the Holy Ghost. There are so many people that are out preaching and the Holy Ghost has not emboldened them. They need the Holy Ghost. You need the Holy Ghost. You need the presence of God in your life. The Bible says, even in 17 verses I read, it says, the Lord said unto Moses, I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, but thou hast found grace in my sight. And I know thee by my name. What is your name? Does God know your name? What is your name? Does God know your name? And he made a statement that I find awesome in the Bible. He said to God himself, he said, I beseech thee, I pray thee, show me your glory. Show me your glory. Hallelujah. Show me your glory. God, if you're going to go with me, show me your glory. Show me your presence. Let me feel your weight, the weight of who you are in my life. Show me your glory. I don't want the wisdom of anybody but the glory of God. I don't want even my bank account because banks may go away pretty soon. I don't want nothing but the presence of God in my life. God, show me your glory. Come on, somebody, reach up for God. God, show me your glory. Amen. I can't do this without you. I can't move forward without you. I can't go to my left or my right without you. Amen. Many people are looking for comfort in the things of this world, in relationships that has never been ordained by God. They're finding comfort in their bank accounts, their jobs that are going by the wayside. We are in a pandemic for real. But the Bible says that he has never seen, David said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or what? His seed being in bread. I don't know about you, but I'm eating every day. I'm eating every day. I'm going to go where I need to go. I'm going to do the things that I need to do because God has shown me his glory. Is there anybody that want to see the glory of God? Well, then you got to take off yourself and you got to get in the way. Get naked before God. I'm not talking about physically. Break yourself. The Bible says that God loves a broken and a contrite spirit. Break yourself. So if you don't want God to leave you, get rid of yourself. Get rid of her. Amen. He said even in the 19th verse, he said, I will make all my goodness go before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and I will show mercy. Amen. But even then, God said, listen, I'm going to show you my glory, but you cannot see me because no man has seen me. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to hide you in the crack of the rock. And when I go by, I'm going to cover you so that you can't see me. And as I'm going by, you're going to see my presence, the weight of his glory. And even if you read in Exodus, you'll see that the weight, the presence of God was so strange, was so awesome, was so fulfilling that it changed everything about Moses. It changed his countenance that was already, I don't know about you, but I want the presence of God in my life. Come on, somebody. I want the presence of God. I want the presence of God. Amen. Do you want the presence of God? In this day of time, I need God more than anything in my life. In this day of time, I need God more than I need that soda pop. I need God more than I need that chicken fried wings. I need God more than I need even my mother. I need God more than anything in my life. If there's anybody in the life, say, God, I need you above any and everything. I need you, God. Hallelujah. I need God. I need God. Come on, somebody, lift up your hands and say, God, I need you. My time is almost up. But God, I need you. Hallelujah. Even in Judges, the Bible talked about Barak and Deborah, Deborah. Amen. When you come, first of all, when you get to the place, in the fourth chapters of Judges and the eighth verse, the Bible says, and Barak said unto her, if thou wilt go with me, thou wilt go with me, then I will go. But if you don't go, then I will not go. It's just that simple. It's just that simple. God, if you don't go with me, then I'm going to stay right here. Hallelujah. I want you to get this in your mind. No matter what your battles are, God is already there. God is already there. God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think. God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think. I need you, my brother, my sister, to declare a new norm. A new norm. This is a new day. And everybody's excited about whatever's getting ready to happen. I'm not putting my trust and confidence in a new man that has the same old ideas. My trust is in the Lord. So I want you to make a declaration today with God. God, I can't do this without you. There is no way. There is no way. There is no way that I can live without you. My sister Dallin used to sing a song, without God, I could do nothing. Without God, I would fail. Without God, I would be like a ship without a sail. I'm going to make an altar call in a second, but for those of you that have really struggled during this time with oppression, that's not of God. Depression, that's not of God. Sickness, brokenness, that's not of God. God wants you to be sound in your mind. He wants you to have joy in the midst of unbearable sorrow. God wants you to have joy that surpasses all understanding. When the world says you should be loony and cuckoo like the song says, God will give you a calm spirit. I ain't got no money in the bank. They done cut off the $600. I don't have no money, but God said that I will supply all your needs. You have to know who the giver of life is. Somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. So I want you to know this today. God's going to turn it around. As you get close to God, God's going to turn it around. God's going to fix that thing that has been broken for so long. That relationship. Husbands, wives that have been apart and separated. God is going to bring you back together. If you want to say, God, I receive it. That son, that daughter that's on the corner selling drugs and even drug addicts, God's going to bring them back home. God, I receive it. We talked the other night about expectant prayer. What you have to do is get in the way of God. That every time God turned around, every place he is, God, there he is, God is. But every time God turned around, there you are with your hands lifted up. That's your hand. God, I worship you. Oh my God. He turned here, there you are right there. God, I believe you. I believe you, God. He turned there. God, I receive my blessings. I receive my help. You got to get in his way. Get closer. Get close to God. Get close. And I guarantee you, he's going to turn it around. God has made a way by his death. So even as we go into this time of worship with the Lord's Supper, I ask that you prepare. You prepare to get your cup, your bread, and your grape juice as we prepare to worship the Lord in the Lord's Supper. I lift my hands to
Corinthians 11 and 23. For I have received of the Lord that which also I have delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, this do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood, this do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he comes. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body.
Thank you.
was the blood.
I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was wrong, he died on the cross. I know it was the blood for me. From the hell, I know it was the blood.
But get close to God. Stay connected to God.
Yes, sir.
Do what you need to do to get into his presence. Turn the TV off. Don't be so infatuated with so much of the bad news. Get to your place where you worship. You worship. You worship. You adore. You exalt him. And I guarantee you, God is going to turn some things around. Father, we thank you for this service. We pray God bless us upon us as we go from this time until next week. In Jesus' name, God bless you, everybody. Thank you.